Long and on the way.
No, it's cool. I'm sorry. I have to interrupt you, ladies.
Oh, no,
it's Rockstar TV camera. So.
Oh, very nice.
Yes, we out here.
Yeah, man. Oh, man. Well, we're just going to have some fun, man. We got a lot of activities going on. We got the skills competitions. We got little seminars going on. But most important, we got the families out here. So I get to climb. And then we got some people going into pros, kids going from college coming back. We've got some pros. I just took a picture with Dave Winfield, man. Oh, good Lord. My knees got weak. I almost got Justin Bieber. I almost started trembling. Hi, Dave. I got a teenage girl on him real quick, but I just keep it together.
TV. What's happening, gentlemen? We got the dads out here. What's cracking?
Rockstar TV. I'ma squeeze in right here. We got a stupendous day today. And as you can see, I'm here. I'ma let these brothers introduce themselves, starting to my left.
How you doing? I'm Devin Davis. I'm from Santa Clarita, California. I am with the Tampa Bay Rays organization.
Brandon Davis from Lakewood, California. I'm 19 years old. And I'm with the Los Angeles Dodgers.
I'm Dalton Blumenfeld. I'm from Los Angeles, California with the Los Angeles Angels.
All three alumni here, draftees. Man, tell me, what does it mean to be back here celebrating 10 years of excellence in the community, 10 years of baseball, 10 years of brotherhood amongst you rock stars? Anybody can go.
It's pretty cool to be back here. I remember being in these guys' shoes right here, so we're trying to help these guys and make sure they get to where we are and even higher up.
Oh, yeah. What about you, Deb?
Man, it's cool to come back here and see all the young kids that when you used to be in their shoes, and now look where you're at now. It's crazy.
I think it's great giving back to the community, having them follow in our footsteps to success, and just, you know, giving back, teaching them the ways.
Awesome. Tell me a little bit about what the Rockstar Baseball program has done for you guys as far as your individual careers are concerned.
They got me prepared to where I needed to be in high school, and then still coming back to Coach E and all that, them helping me out, fielding, hitting, everything. It was really good.
I mean, for me, they got me prepared for a lot of things. They got me prepared for baseball, but most importantly, they got me prepared for life so I can go out and play and still be a good person and be a good civilian. So I think that was the biggest thing. They let us travel the world. You know, they took us to a lot of events where, you know, most kids don't get to do. So I think it's something awesome that Coach E and everybody's doing for us.
Awesome. What about you, Coach?
Coach E taught us a lot about life skills and everything, responsibility, just, you know, getting us ready for high school and then stepping above and getting ready for college.
Tell us a little bit about work ethic. You guys obviously have been working super hard at your craft. Give a little advice to the kids out here who are trying to follow in you guys' footsteps.
I mean, whatever you put your mind to, you can do it if you work at it. That's all I got to say. Coach E, you know, I know y'all be working with Coach E, and he'll get you ready. So just trust in him and get your work done, and they'll all be all right.
Never take a play off. That's all I can say. Just keep working. Just never stop.
It starts young. I think the most important thing is grades. Grades, without grades, you can't play. So stay in school, study hard, play hard. School comes first, though.
Stay in school, study hard, play hard. Never take a pitch off, man. Hey, listen to these guys. These guys are tried and true, man. They rock stars just like you. This is Rockstar TV. Matt Ali, we out here. Where you at? Thanks, fella. Check it out, we got Dominic Smith, Hunter Greene, and Marcus Wilson. How y'all doing, fellas?
Good,
how's
good.
It feel to be here at the 10th anniversary celebrating 10 years of excellence of Rockstar Baseball?
This is
is awesome. This is a great event to be at, and I'm glad to be here, and this is going to be a lot of fun.
I'm going to ask the original BBG, because y'all at home, man. Tell me, what is this, man, to be back home, be at your alma mater, giving back to the kids, coming out here representing, man?
Yeah, this is definitely a great event to be a part of and just give back to the community. Definitely an awesome experience, and hopefully it's an awesome time for all the kids who came out and for the community. It's going to be a great day.
Dominic, first appearance at the Futures game this year, man. You've been working hard, man. Career is taking off, man. What does it mean to make that appearance? By the way, I was at the wheel call, bro. I didn't get my tickets, man. I was out there in San Diego standing in line. I said, Damo said he got me, but he wouldn't let me in.
Yeah. Definitely the Futures game was a great experience. And, you know, the Mets, the organization have done a great job with helping me at developing my career. So, I mean, I give them a lot of thanks. And, you know, it's a lot of just hard work and stuff like that. I'm just trying to make another push to get to the next level.
Awesome, man. Tell me a little bit about BBG and your baseball generation, man. What's cracking with that? Because that's pretty dope, right?
So BBG stands for Baseball Generations, and it's a little, it started as a little clique that a few of my tight friends started at Sarah High School, and we pretty much just want to help the kids who are getting ready to go into showcases just know what scouts want to see and how to prepare for those things. So we're trying to integrate the younger kids and getting them ready to take the next jump in their career, which is college ball or professional baseball.
That's awesome, man. Tell me a little bit about playing with the rock stars, man, and what this organization means to young African Americans coming up.
Oh, the rock stars, you know, they've been implemented throughout the inner cities since I was a kid. So, you know, they took us to many places and many tournaments, and, you know, we learned a lot, and we had a great time. You know, we're all a close-knit family. That's why, you know, the turnout is what it is today. We all came out to support and to just show the city that Rockstar Nation, Rockstar Baseball, you know, it's a powerful thing.
Hunter Greene, the man with the 98-mile power fastball, my brother, UCLA commit. He is going to be the one to watch here in the up-and-coming draft. My brother, tell me a little bit about your relationship with the Rockstar Baseball Club and Eric Aldridge.
You know, it's been amazing. You know, I've been really young, and to be able to, you know, play with the Rockstars and be a part of such a great family, it's been amazing. Coach E has been awesome. All the other players, you know, growing up and always playing up with guys, it's been great. They've been great mentors, and I've had a great time just being a part of a great, great team and great people in general, and it's been awesome.
Awesome, man. I've been reading a lot about you, man. I've seen you in the area code games, and you're a different breed, my brother. Notably, your approach to the game. I've watched you warm up, and after the guys leave the field, you're still out there warming up. You're taking pride in your game, and you go to a little extra length. Can you tell me a little bit about your work ethic?
Yeah, you know, always staying healthy and you know, working hard, and, you know, like you said, the extra work on and off the field has really helped me a lot, and staying on my routine and making sure I take care of myself, and also, you know, inspiring other people to also take care of themselves, and, you know, just help people in general and help others around me get better.
Awesome, man. Hey, we appreciate you coming out, man. And you're an awesome player, man.
Thank you.
Guys, the one to watch right here. Now, we got an OG, Marcus Wilson. He's on Rockstar TV all the time, man.
Yeah.
But check it out. I saw you hit your first jack in the Midwest League this year, huh? How's that feel, man? You still out there banging them?
Yeah, so if they're banging, I felt good in August, man. Just trying to get a good pitch to hit and execute, because they gave me that chance and I can't let them down.
Hey, BBG, back home, man. Tell me about this. What does this community forum mean to you today? 10th anniversary, 10 years.
Everything, man. I mean, this. I would have never saw this coming, man. When we were growing up, man, I didn't know it was gonna be a dynasty like this, man. And it's really good to see, you know. And I love the turnout, man. Everybody's here. It's all one family, like Damo said, man. So it's just really, it's just a blessing in disguise, really.
Hey, man, give me a little advice to the youth out here, man. They see you out here grinding, man. Tell them something that they can take home with them.
You gotta want it. You gotta want it and just keep grinding, man. That's all I can say, man. It's hard. It's a hard grind, but it'll be all worth it in the end. Trust me.
Marcus Wilson. Dominic Smith, we got Hunter Greene. Hey, this is Rockstar TV, man. This is huge right now. Check it out. If you're not here, man, I don't know what you're doing, bro. You out there watching TV. You out there eating Zoom Zooms and Wham Wham. You should be here. If you're a baseball player, you should be here. Community Baseball Fest, man, it's cracking. Cracking. Get in here. Oh, I'm still on? Oh, man, we got BBG. Who we got here? I'm going to just let these cats introduce themselves. We got the college gang right here. BBG Generations. We got,
Tim Rivar.
Tim tried to hijack the mic.
Chase Aldridge.
You guys been out here grinding, man. You guys all made it on the college level. Tell me, how did the Rockstar Baseball Club aid in getting you to where you guys are at right now? Anybody can elaborate.
Well, the Rockstars, from a young age, they taught us all the fundamentals of baseball. So going into the next levels, we always knew like the basic things, so we're already ahead in that aspect.
Hey, there you go. We got Chase Aldridge. Here's a person that came up from a baby under this Rockstar banner, man. Tell us what is it to see how big this thing has turned out since you've been a pup.
It's crazy. I mean, all these dudes are here and play with growing up and seeing where we all are right now. It's really cool to see all these guys, you know, how far we've come as a program and, you know, all what everyone's doing. It's really cool.
Awesome. AJ Fritz here. What's up, my brother? Good to see you, man. Come in here. Elaborate a little bit on your relationship with Rockstar Baseball. And how it helped you out.
Definitely. I mean, growing up playing for the Rockstars, it was an amazing experience. It taught us how to play with a confidence and a swagger, work hard day in and day out, and still have fun. So it's definitely a blessing.
Awesome. What's up, fella?
How's it going?
Hey, spit something for me about what Rockstar Baseball means to you, fella.
Me? I mean, it got me out of the little league phase and taught me how to play a real game of baseball. So, I mean, I appreciate it a lot.
Rockstar Baseball taught me, like, when you're with your team, it's a family. Like, you gotta have a family when you're playing. And everybody just gelled so well together, like, from Eric making us all, like, just one. So.
Original BBG.
Oh,
right,
yeah,
here,
exactly.
Man.
Exactly.
Man, y'all at home, bro. This is Sarah, man. We on y'all turf. Y'all alma mater, man. Y'all tell me.
Oh, yeah.
What is it, man? This is super big. Look, we got EO, man. Come on. What's up, EDR? We got the leadership right here.
I mean, it's good to be back seeing my brothers out here. We all doing well. We all started out so young with the Rockstar, so having fun today.
Awesome, man. Come on, tell us, man. Tell me, man, about these young gentlemen right here, man, and what it's like coaching a group of kids that showed and proved, man. They're coming back and giving it back, bro.
I tell you what. You should probably ask the people that we used to play.
Yes.
Because we used to give it to them.
Yeah.
You know, and I'm just proud of what they've been able to accomplish as ball players, as young men.
How you doing? I met you before over at the Academy. Okay. Rockstar TV, man. This is the first. We got a Hall of Famer. 33rd man to be inducted into the Baseball Hall of Fame. Philanthropist, businessman, and all around great guy. Dave Winfield, how you doing, my brother?
I'm doing fantastic. Glad to be here. Today.
Man, tell me what brings you out here to this event today.
Well, Rockstars and Inglewood Baseball Fund. Interested in baseball continuing to thrive and be a part of our community, offer opportunities for kids to grow up strong, stay in the right direction, maybe get into college, maybe think about a professional career, but this is just to keep baseball a part of our communities across the country. And you guys have been doing it. Rockstar's been doing it for the last 10 years.
Yes, sir.
And so I'm here to offer support in a number of different ways, and I'm glad to see the turnout. Beautiful.
Oh, man, thank you so much. Can you tell me a little bit about the link between the elite development camp and what you guys have going with Eric over here?
Well, that's a whole different animal.
Okay.
I work for the Major League Baseball Players Association.
Okay.
And in conjunction with Major League Baseball, we put a fund together, and we're bringing kids down to the old Dodgers spring training camp during the summer.
Awesome.
Kids, I believe, 12 to 15 in one category for a week, and then maybe 15 to 17 beyond that. So that'll happen again. Last year, I was able to alert the Rockstars group and the connections, and we sent for, I think, maybe about 15 kids down there. And so when you expose them to baseball at a high level, professional baseball players on, you know, right with them all week, they come back a changed person. And we're going to do it again this year.
Awesome. Tell me one more thing. I heard you talk about purposeful practice.
Oh, yeah.
Can you elaborate on that as far as for these for the youngsters out here?
Well, that's part of, I think, I call it, there's five levels to be as good as you can be.
Yes, sir.
First one is first of all, you got God-given ability. Next level is know the rules, technique, fundamental. Mm-hmm. Third is purposeful practice. Don't go out there just lollygagging and going through the motions. That won't work. Next level, physical fitness. And then next level, mental toughness. So right in the middle, that purposeful practice, that's what kids have to do. Just don't go through the motions.
One more thing. I heard you talk about African Americans playing the game of baseball, and you referred to some as the three C's. Could you elaborate on that for me, please?
Oh yeah, well we're getting into the book that I wrote back in 2008 called Dropping the Ball. I thought that people were dropping the ball in a lot of respects. I won't go into the whole continuity has been broken.
Yes, sir.
You can't grow up and play baseball for nothing. You know, there's a number of C's. There's a number of things that I call that are very important to the culture of baseball. But right now, let's just say I'm going to cover some of these things with the kids today. But that was one of them. The continuity's been broken. You can't play it from 0 to 18 or, you know, 8 to 18 and, you know, in high school and your community like they used to do. So we're trying to bridge that gap.
10th anniversary, we're celebrating Rockstar Baseball Club. We out here with no other than David Winfield, Hall of Famer, man. We out here. Where you at? Thank you so much, my brother.
You got it.
Thank
you. You got it.
Appreciate you so much.
All right.
Hey, what's up?
The third generation.
Good to be back amongst all these baseball peers, man.
It's good to see these guys, man. You guys are hilarious.
Awesome, man.
Yeah.
Yeah,
bud.
Right now.
I got the real, catch it by my real camera, huh?
How you doing? All right.
I was on a mission.
Hey, Lisa, how you doing?
I slipped right on by.
It's all good.
Ali, what you got over there, man? You got something new over there?
Yeah, I got the Wake and Rakes over there. Yes, sir. Right now.
Is that live?
Yes, ma'am. All the way live. Hey, R, did you not step it by?
Right now, talking education, baseball, and college scholarship process. I know that's for the parents. If it's like my son, he will have nothing to do with that. He'll try to get away from that. Now, I want to go over today of some of today's activities. There's going to be an on-field showcase by local professional college and high school players taking place on the field shortly. As you can see, some of the kids, they're wandering. Some of them are from high school quickly. Professional, it's great that they give it back, giving back to the community of baseball. Let's give them a round of applause for coming back, giving back. Don't have to just talk in place. I'm not on the bus, I'm on the bridge. Just talking. I'm talking to you guys. Come on.
foremost, man, thanks for coming out. Second, man, this is about fun, man. Just, you know, we all met through the game of baseball, whether coaches, players playing together, teammates or whatever, wherever you're from. I mean, that's how we all got together, so that's what we're here for, man. We're just going to throw the ball around. You got all these guys that look up to you guys. We talk about you guys all the time to these young guys that we coach. And now they get to see you guys in person, which is a big deal. After we finish up, Tim's going to take over. We're going to take these guys through a little bit of a clinic on the field. But we're just here to have fun, man. We got food, drinks, whatever. My apologies for you guys that stayed out last night and, you know, it's got challenged this morning. It's all good. I know the feeling. But, yeah, we're just going to go out and get Jay. Anything?
Happy to see you guys and see you guys all together. More importantly, for you guys that have come back and out of here, man, really appreciate that. To see something that we started and to see all you guys that got taller than me, bigger than me, and just, you know, I'm really proud of you guys, especially you guys that are in school and finishing up. Pro guys, I mean, you just do what you do. You guys are special. You know what I mean? That's just what it is. You were born to do that. You guys that are going to get your education, though, for me, that's how I was able to buy a home. That's how I was able to take care of my family. And I used this game to be able to do that. So keep bugging away and keep doing that. All right?
Yeah. We got HOF over here. Last one. Yeah.
All I can say is everybody, welcome. Good to see you out here. I love it that you're still playing the game of baseball. It's meant the world to me. For those who don't know me, yeah, I'm in the Hall of Fame, but I played professional baseball 22 years. I got a college education, traveled the world, made a beautiful name for myself, and part of what I'm doing here is because there aren't many places around this country where there are this number of kids of color, athletes too, intelligent kids, and community people that want to continue to promote the game of baseball. So I'm going to do a few things, all I can within my power, to support you guys in these programs so that you can have a place to play and grow and become all you can be. So I'm happy for you. It's good to see you, and I'm excited for you. Give it your best. Let's have some fun today.
Yeah, let's get this money. All right, Jay.
Hey, you guys, we obviously know it's choppy out there. I'm going to hit them slow to you, you know what I mean? Just let you just have fun with it. Let your kids see your arm more than anything. All right, yeah, I got it.
What up, though?
Ladies of baseball here. Hello, ladies.
Hi.
Kids in the community is just
a sight to see. I did not think 10 years later we would be here, but I feel like we're supposed to be here. And that what Eric is doing for the community means more than he knows, and that it's bigger than baseball. It is community and it's family, and that is everything.
Gentlemen, how y'all enjoying this baseball fest out here,
good,
man?
This is awesome right here. This is priceless, man.
You gotta be a rock star, man.
See all of this talent, man, in one location on the field, that's taking good. Ground balls, infield, outfield. You can't beat it, man.
There's some players out here.
Great example for the young guys coming up, man, to see these older guys that have, you know, went to college, major leagues, minor leagues, is doing it. Yes. Excellent, man.
Oh, it's really good, man. You guys gotta come check this out.
Tell me a little bit about your relationship with JG and the Rockstars and how you guys get down.
Well, man, I've been with JG Baseball for about 3 years. Was introduced to Eric by James Guerrero. And, man, we've been close ever since. We do a lot of tie-ins with the Rockstars. He invites us out to some of his events. Bring him our players, he sends us players, so it's a good thing going, man. Good thing.
Appreciate you, coach.
Thank you.
Man, still swinging that back, you raking?
Yep.
Hey, man, what do you think about this event out here today?
I think it's pretty cool.
Yeah.
It's like people come out here to show their skills. Can do everything. Mm-hmm.
You got a lot of ball power out here, man. A lot of players out here. These are big names out here, man. How's it feel to be out here, man, and see all these guys out here?
Pretty cool, because you don't really get to see them as often as you get to. Like, you don't get to really see any people like getting drafted out of the chute right out of high school, college. You don't get to see that.
Well, this is awesome, man. Thanks for coming out, man.
Thank you.
All right. Film here, what's going on? It's the food station right here, huh? Yep, Grubhub is cracking. What y'all got here, ladies? Y'all got a little panda. Yeah. Getting in. How y'all doing, man? What you think about this baseball fest out here today?
Great opportunity for the kids, man.
He like, I'm eating, man. You trying to stick this thing in my face, man? I'm eating. There we go. What's up, fellas? Rockstar Nation, everybody mouth is full over here, man. Look, what you got going on right here? Let me see. You eating rice, man? What else you got? What you got over here? What's orange chicken? That's the order of the day? Right. You had hot dog. All right.
Panda Express, huh?
Exactly, man.
Thank Panda Express, great grub.
Yeah. There it is there. Thanks, fellas. What y'all got going on, gentlemen? Y'all eating, y'all grubbing? Everybody satisfied? Y'all having a great time out here? Awesome.
Hello.
What's up? What you got to say? Yeah, tell me, man. Tell me what to do, man. What does this 10th anniversary celebration of Rockstar Baseball mean for a young cat like you? What division are you in? What does this mean for a 10U play? Huh? Come on, you said you like to talk. Now hit me up, man. Come on, man.
It means Rockstars have been going for 10 years,
mm-hmm.
and they'd like to celebrate it.
Yeah, so how many years have you been with the organization?
1.5.
This year? Yeah, so you completed a full year? Going into your second year right now, huh? This is your second year. So how do you feel like playing? How do you feel being a rock star?
It's really good. Mm-hmm. I really kind of feel good.
Oh yeah? Oh yeah? Come here, you tell me, man. How's it feel to be a rock star, young man?
Very good.
Yeah? How'd you find out about this rock star program, and how'd you come? It's kind of,
Hey, my uncle is famous. And that's how I started Rockstar. This is my first year.
Awesome. You like baseball? Well, say baseball is fun.
Baseball is fun.
Awesome. Thank you, man. What, you want to tell me baseball is fun?
You hit me up.
I mean, it's all right.
Baseball's fun because,
especially here.
Take me your book. Like, to my like other sports, you get you last longer, and you get paid more.
Dad,
that's why I like baseball.
Dad, yeah. What position do you play?
I play shortstop, center field, and catcher.
Awesome. Thank you.
How y'all enjoying yourself at this baseball fest out here, man? What y'all think about this, man?
It's good, man. It's good for the kids. Crawl's giving back. College players giving back.
It is. Well, my first time being out, me and my son and family overall, this is a good atmosphere for all the kids. It's real nice. I like what's going on with the Rockstar.
Behind the scenes to create special opportunities for our players. A lot of times, they don't want the recognition, but today we're going to give it to them. First person is a guy that I've known, Coach's son. Last year, when we took our first team to Cooperstown, he stepped up and volunteered to donate money so that they all could go to Cooperstown and purchase gifts. And he's done a lot of other great things for our organization. At this time, I'd like to bring him up and present our first Community Impact Award to Mr. Russell Greene. Russell.
Thank you, Russell.
Cooperstown. And Russell just handed me an envelope to sponsor that group as well, so. Thanks, Russell.
What up?
The next Community Impact Award I'd like to give out. And to a guy, every time we would travel on the road, he'd be there to help us out with logistics, drive kids, with his hotels, doing extra cooking, whatever the case may be, he was always there to volunteer and help out. And he's been doing the same thing today. A good friend of mine, his son's a fantastic player at St. Monica High School, Mr. Allen Lorenz.
You won't by yourself.
Doing the good work and not making too big a deal out of it. He was very instrumental in helping the rock stars on early stages. He was very instrumental in that 2013 Sierra Championship banner that hangs out there at Pepperdine University. And I think he skipped out on his draft to Duncan McKinnon.
You got it, man. Appreciate it. Turn around and take a picture.
Hey, Duncan!
There's a quote on it from the great Jackie Robinson, and it says, "A life is not important except in the impact that it has on other lives." And so that's something that makes the rock star special. It's not about just me. It's not just about the coaches. It's not about the players. It's about everyone. And so this final award, this day cannot happen unless he reached out to me. Did not have to, does not need to, has had a fantastic career. He's now working for the MLB Players Association. And he doesn't know that he's getting this award, but, you know, he's in a short period of time has really done a lot. And I'd like to have him just say a few words. And that's University of Minnesota graduate, Hall of Fame outfielder, Mr. Dave Winfield.
Oh man, I appreciate that. I just can't.
Here you go, here you go. Concrete, one, two, three.
What's that? Mark's brief. They always say, remember the five B's when you walk up there. Be brief, brother, be brief.
Can I do that?
Now listen, look, this is, it's been a fantastic day. I just wanna say thank you to all the parents and all the volunteers and all the coaches who have supported these kids year after year after year. You don't get that recognition, but it wouldn't happen without you. Put your hands together for all these coaches and volunteers. All you players out there, just a couple words I'm gonna tell you. I started years ago just playing baseball back in Minnesota. Didn't know what I could do, but I found something I loved. I had a passion for the game. I had great coaches that took me places. Got me an education, got me a job, a career. I'm well known, I've traveled the world, I meet all the presidents. I do all that, I live pretty good now. But it's because of baseball. So maybe you can do the same thing too. And I just hope that, I'm just gonna say this. I hope that you guys continue to keep baseball strong and a part of these communities. I give you guys a tremendous amount of credit. I'm gonna do what I can to support you with certain resources and such. But I just came out today to see how you're doing, and I support you. I love you guys, keep doing it.
So, just a couple more things real quick. You know, we couldn't have this happen again. We'd like to thank Adateam, Panda, Coca-Cola, Enterprise Rental Car, the Watlett family, the Freeman family, Peninsula General, of course, Dave Winfield, host of other people, Pecora family, Yola's family, Phil's family. Got a lot of people, Vredenburg family, Taku Nagashima, Lions family, Caremore Health Benefits. All these people stepped up to make this day happen. I also like to present an award to another one of our volunteers who, you know, cut his vacation short. And he sent me pictures from where he was from, and I'm not sure I would have came back early, but he came back, he was in Hawaii. And he came back early to support this, as he always does behind the scenes. That's Mr. Henry Brandon. Henry.
Thanks, man. Really? Yeah. Wow. This is a surprise.
All right, Mr. Brandon.
One, two, three. One more. One, two, three. Good. That one by yourself, Mr. Brandon.
All that space.
And that's the volunteer team over here to my right. And I'm going to have them raise their hands. Stacey Lewis. I'd like to thank and recognize the person who allows me to be on this field through the years, let me follow a passion of mine, whether I was down at UC San Diego playing baseball in college, supporting our sons playing baseball, but allowing me to just follow my passion. That's my wife, Tiffany, right here. At this time, we're going to recognize a group of young men who, they did it. They won a championship in 2013 at Dodger Stadium. Woo-hoo! And since we're here on their campus, I thought it would be appropriate to recognize each and every one of them and let you guys know who they are and what they accomplished. So, I'm going to get a little assistance here if you can hand me one of those cubes. And I don't think they're all here, but I think I got most of them here. But first and foremost, we got a few of the coaches here. I'd like to have them come up. They were a member of that coaching staff, Martell London. Come on up, Martell. Kevin Martin. Big Cam, where you at?
Oh, there we go.
RT, where you at, RT? Coming in. Here comes Gavin. I think you guys need to understand that, you know, coaching high school baseball is about love. It ain't about too much else other than the love of the game and love of young people. And these people have committed a great deal of their time and their talents as former players to give back to the community and to my alma mater, Sarah High School. So, at this time, I'm just going alphabetical order as I see it on this list.
Still at Fresno State?
Yep. Infielder, now at Fresno State University. This dude was nice up the middle. I think he should have been the starting shortstop. I say it, Ryan Dawson. Where's Ryan?
I agree.
What is your thing?
I use a catcher on the team, Rob Hunt. Robert here? Robert Hunt? Rob not here, okay. Vincent Butler here? I think Vince is here.
Vince here?
Yep. One of the arms on the mound that helped out throughout the season, Vincent Butler. Pitcher, outfielder. Here he comes, make your way up. If you don't hurry up, we're going to pass it on to somebody else. I actually knew this young man from Darby Park, man, coaching with his daddy.
Coach.
One of the best athletes I've ever coached. Starting left field in Dodger Stadium. Number 7, Morgan Lomax. There he is.
Somebody said put a shirt on. He said, Suns out, guns out.
He made his name in that championship game by hitting a home run off the left field pole at Dodger Stadium. Now a member of the Arizona Diamondbacks organization. Known this young man since he was 8 years old. Marcus Wilson. He's a pitcher on the team, Tommy Bathwell. Another young man, I don't think he's here, but he played for the Heckers.
No, I'm skipping those guys.
Played outfield for the Rockstars, Hector Ramos. I think he's playing college ball down in Florida. The shortstop on that team, Khalil Benson. Cameron Gray was an outfielder on that team. Cameron, where you at? Cameron Gray. Yeah. Looking like D. Gordon.
Right. D. Gordon there.
Second baseman on that team, leadoff hitter, Duncan McKinnon.
Okay.
Left-handed pitcher and outfielder, Mateo Brambilla.
There you go, dog.
Two of the guys right now over at USC playing baseball, the Bates brothers. They're not here, but Rose wants to give them a shout out. Roosevelt and Solomon Bates.
Yeah.
The infielder now at the University of Illinois. He had a lot of joy at Dodger Stadium giving it back to his folks at Miracosta. Trent Hammond. Yeah. I saw his dad here, but I didn't see him. The rabbit, I think he's down at school right now.
Just left
on Friday. You go see him at San Diego State University. Chap, Denzel Chapman. He was the only freshman on the team. Finished his career at Narbonne High School. The big fella, Chewy, Isaiah Flowers.
Paul.
The last three guys That's Mr. Chapman. Big Chap.
The only freshman beside him need a bunch of them.
And the last three guys I'd like to introduce, the captains of the team. One of the smartest, brightest players I've ever coached. We'll have him in the dugout with me at any time. Future leader in this world. Mr. Ashton Edior.
Job still open, Ash.
And I'm taking this guard to any fight.
Offered him a job.
The captain, the general, Timothy Rivard Jr.
They got the day for you right there.
And last but not least, when he ate, everyone ate. Dominic Smith.
Go, Mets, go!
This is unprepared. We have a special award, a special presentation. Coach E does not know this. Eric does not know. Chase Aldridge, Chase, can you come up here, please? We have a special presentation for you, and also here we go.
This is. I think everyone can say that we're lucky to be here, and part of the reason we're all here is because of Coach Eric, and you know, he's opened a lot of doors for a lot of people, given us a lot of opportunities. And I can, you know, attest to that personally. Couldn't have been where I'm at today for sure without him and my dad. But just giving this award to him, putting this all together, and yeah, everyone's clapped up.
So one of the things that I'm also known for is kind of being soft when the guys say they want to do something. So they want to hit a few baseballs for everybody. We're going to spend 10, 20 minutes hitting the baseball a little bit. And enjoy the show, everyone. DJ, you can go ahead and get it going again. Fella, out of Notre Dame High School, 17-year-old. UCLA commit. Hunter Greene.
I'm running nervous.
Oh! Yeah.
Lego, hey, oh, hey. Oh, yeah.
Little two coming out.
I said, I got it. What you expect me to do?
Oh!
I'm on a whole other level. If you
hold on, hold on, hold on. That was your best list, too.
Don't stop, hey. Don't stop, hey. Run a man on that beat. Run a man on that beat.
Hey, we got you. Hey, Frank, can I get a
bucket? Do your dance, do your dance, do your dance, hey.
All
right, I'm gonna pick. We got a quick pick. Next up, Westchester High School fourth round pick of the Cardinals. He got his fan club over the dugout because he coached the young ones over there. He got his whole squad behind him. Kenny Walls. Jp Crawford.
Yeah.
erase that off yet. Erase it.
Hey, y'all got to delete that.
Delete.
Cut that.
Hey,
hey, everybody! Everybody, let's give it up for these guys. Yeah. Taking the time to come out, do a little show.
We done.
What does this mean? Here, give me the mic.
Go ahead, Solomon.
What about you say?
What does it mean to be a part of this 10-year celebration here at Rockstar Baseball, man?
I don't know.
What up, though? Rockstar Nation.
How's it going?
Sir.
Name's Will.
What's up?
Hey, don't try to leave, man. I already caught you, bro. You got sneaking away. You on the candy caramel. What up? Jinx, what it do? Right.
I'm so happy the sun is shining. I'm so happy. Beautiful turnout.
Yeah, I'm amazed. There's a lot of players here. It's really nice to see the love coming back.
All the alums that started out playing Rockstar Baseball, glad to have them back.
And I think they're happy to be back. They're, you know, hanging out in the dugout. They've been talking to each other. Haven't seen each other in a long time, so it's nice for them to catch up, too. So.
They think they're back in high school.
You gentlemen enjoying the baseball fest? Awesome, man. Oh, man, you always look good. If you don't look good, we don't look good, bro.
Our nation baseball fest, we've had Dave Winfield in the house, Hunter Greene, AJ Fitz, Dom Smith. Oh my gosh, the names are endless. And these are all young men who have come through our program at the generous contribution. Yes, at the generous personal contribution of Eric Allridge. And so we want to tell him thank you. There's no money that we can ever repay, but just want to tell him thank you for developing our boys and bringing baseball back. Thank you.
You're a rock star, bro. I know you're here with your Sarah fam, but tell me what it do right now, man. Tell me how it do, bro. Come on, man. I'm camera shy.
Sure you are. Sure you are.
It's exciting because I've seen a lot of people that I haven't seen in a long time. Watch these kids turn into men, a lot of boys turn into men. It's very interesting. I like it. I'm enjoying myself.
Oh, what is it about? It's about community, it's about skill development, it's about excellence, it's about competition, everything that makes baseball and our community great. Woo!
A lot of work right here, my brother.
Yeah, you know.
Great accomplishment, man.
A lot of glory.
Hey, man, yeah, it's a hell of a event, E.
You know what?
I'd like to commend you, my brother.
I don't think it could have turned out any better. What they say, the proof is in the pudding. And I could be so proud of every level of today's event, you know, from the volunteers, our committee, coaches, former players, current players, you know. This is like a once in a lifetime type of day, so we're just so appreciative of everything, the media coming out, everybody coming out. You know, this is awesome, man. Beautiful day, man. Collaborating, a lot of wonderful things, man. Rockstar Nation, Baseball Generations, Yard Kid, Sarah High School, LA. Awesome. Awesome, man. Like I said, it's everybody in my book is just has such equal standing, and it's because everybody brought, you know, what they could to the table, and this is what proves it, you know. This is what proves it. This is it. Rockstar Nation. Rockstar Nation. Go get some E, baby. Man. Amazing.